What's going on? This is Jason from G-Style Magazine, and it's time to recap our geothermal installation with Dandelion Energy. So we finished our installation back in June, which was a little bit later than I was hoping. I was hoping to have it done a little bit more in the winter so we could enjoy some of that kind of winter warming. But nevertheless, it was finished in June and we got plenty of time to enjoy some summer cooling. So now that our installation is done and summer is over, it's time to recap and talk about just what our geothermal installation and how it has been acting since we've had it now. So let's kind of go through a recap of what's happened since our installation finished in June. So first and foremost, our land went back to normal. When the trenching aspect of the install was done, our land was kind of crazy looking and a little bit rough, but it did snap back as quick as possible, you know, as quickly as expected. So I laid down some grass seed and raked it in all over the area that was affected. And about a month and a half, it kind of returned to normal. So that was excellent and glad to kind of see grass, and I'm glad that didn't take too long to kind of return to normal. Second was our electric bill, and it did go up some, but that is kind of to be expected. So before our geothermal installation with Dandelion, we had no centralized AC. So we might have had one AC window unit in the master bedroom, which we only turned on at a time when it really got hot. So this summer was kind of like the first one where we would have kind of that running centralized AC throughout the summer. So while our electric bill did go up, it wasn't too bad, and you know, and as you can see from this energy usage chart, that our energy stayed pretty level from what it was last year. Definitely, you know, stayed about just about equal or a little bit more. And again, it was to be expected, but it wasn't as much of a bite as I thought it was going to be. Now, there are tons of benefits, and one of my favorite is just having centralized AC is amazing. To just have to set the temperature, which we set pretty much at about 78 to 79, so our upstairs gets a little bit warmer than our downstairs. So during the summer, even at the highest points, upstairs was comfortable, downstairs was a little bit chillier, but at times we honestly didn't even know that it was super hot outside. Even when days it hit like 91 degrees, we really didn't know until we stepped outside and it was like, whoa, it is hot. So just having that, when we didn't have that before, was definitely a plus. Got spoiled with centralized AC, I'm not gonna lie, and now that I have it, I'm never looking back. Now, other than that, it's pretty much a set it and forget it thing. So like I said, we set our temperature to about 78 to 79, and whenever the temperature rose above that, that's kind of when it kicked in and was called stage one cooling, with a kind of a low fan that just kind of kept the temperature at that 78 to 79. And if there was ever a time where it needed to go a little bit higher, or if I set the degrees maybe 2 degrees lower, then it would kick into stage two, which would blow much faster. So I pretty much left it in stage one and kept that at 78, 79. And it was kind of a success and forget it. The only times I really had to mess with it is, like I said, the upstairs was a little bit warmer. So at times when it did get a little bit warmer upstairs, I might adjust a degree or two just to kind of cool the upstairs down. Other than that, I pretty much just left it as it is and didn't have to touch it through the whole summer. So that's pretty much been our installation. So our installation finished about the first week of June, and we've had it throughout the whole summer. Is at points it's hit like 91 degrees and it's been comfortable in the house, and that's been a godsend. But let me see, I'm trying to think if there's any downside right now. Honestly, there is no downside that I've had with the installation per se, or since I've had it installed. So I'm pretty happy where we're at right now. So I'm definitely happy with how it's cooled during the summer, and we can't wait to experience some of that winter warming. It's already starting to get a little bit cooler in New York City, or New York State, because I'm upstate. And we've already switched the mode from cooling only to a mix of heating and cooling. So we've right now set our heating to about 74, 75. So if it gets lower than that, that's when the heating will kick in. And we set the cooling side still at the 78 to 79, actually a little bit about 78 to 80. And if it goes above that, that's when we kick into cooling. So I'm hoping that it stays perfectly with no issues, works flawlessly, and this winter will be just what it is, comfortable. And I think we'll do one more video segment for this, maybe next year, right after the winter, so I can kind of go back and talk about how that winter's been. But Dandelion Energy geothermal heat pump, I have no complaints. I'm glad I did it. If you're interested in getting geothermal with Dandelion yourself and you happen to be in the New York State region, I'll leave a link in the description below so you can kind of sign up for it yourself. And if you sign up now, you can get $500 back once you've done your install. So a little bunny back at you. But for now, I am Jason Anderson. You are watching G-Style Magazine. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.